Welcome, everyone, to the second round of the NCAA tournament and the Midwest region from Omaha, Nebraska. With the winner going to the Sweet 16. With Dan Bonner, this is Kevin Harlan. And let's take a look at our lineups today, the starting five for each team, and what matchup have you circled for this one?
Kevin, the guard matchup, Wink Adams, Curtis Terry against Russell Robinson and Mario Chalmers. UNLV can't win unless they win that matchup.
Lon Kruger is in his fourth season as the coach of the Runnin' Rebels, the eighth seed. And Bill Self is in his fifth year at KU. Our officials this afternoon, a veteran of 15 NCAA tournaments, Leslie Jones. Of 9 tournaments and 1 Final Four, J.D. Collins. Of 8 NCAA tournaments, Terry Weimer. UNLV finished in second place in the Mountain West Conference, but they were the tournament champions, upsetting top 20 BYU. Kansas, the co-Big 12 regular season champion. The Big 12 postseason tournament champion. This is their 19th consecutive NCAA tournament. It's the Runnin' Rebels and the Jayhawks, and here we go. Kansas took care of Portland State on Thursday. UNLV crushed Kent State.
And UNLV opens in the man-to-man, and right away Kansas goes inside.
What do you like about the Runnin' Rebels?
Well, the Runnin' Rebels will really get after you defensively. They're a solid, solid defensive team. They'll try to get the ball up the court quickly to get a fast break, but if not, they will run some time off the clock, look for the good open opportunity.
This is Darger, outside Terry with a three. A big time hit by a former walk-on, Curtis Terry of UNLV.
That is his 66th three-point basket of the year, and he has got to be a big scorer today.
What to like about Kansas?
Kansas, they have so many weapons. 6 guys who've scored more than 20 points in a game this year. They can come at you from a lot of different directions.
A switch on defense. Robinson outside. Chalmers, and the shot clock is down to 9. Chalmers hit all those threes against Texas, and he misses a long-range triple right there. The aggressive rush can't hold on to it for JKU, and it is off of UNLV. So Kansas will inbound.
You got a perfect example of the kind of attacking defense that UNLV likes to play. They will pressure the ball. They will try to get you out of your rhythm. Kansas with a tremendous size advantage, though, Kevin. They ought to be able to get some work done on the offensive boards.
Against about everybody they play. Robinson. Darnell Jackson over Darger. And picked up by Rene Rougeau.
Rene Rougeau, another guy who started his career at UNLV as a walk-on. This UNLV lineup includes 2 former walk-ons and an ex-air conditioning repairman.
And Kansas has a lineup littered with McDonald's All-Americans, recruited by Bill Self. Here you've got Robinson, who's Player of the Year in Manhattan. He works now against Corey Bailey. Chalmers, Player of the Year from Alaska. Jackson, high-low game with Arthur. Knocked away inside by Wink Adams. The shot clock at 22.
We talked about the defensive intensity of UNLV, and something's going to have to give here. Kansas, 10th best in the country, 3-point shooting. UNLV, 12th best in holding opponents down from the 3-point line.
Here's Rush. Screen by Arthur, trying to pick and roll with Robinson. Jackson, who has improved so much this season. His senior year at Kansas, setting a screen. A triple drive by Robinson and a Runnin' Rebel foul.
It's Rene Rougeau, I think, who's going to get called for the foul.
It is number 1. And he was one of those walk-ons you were talking about.
Right, he's a walk-on. Terry was a walk-on. There's Rougeau. Rougeau, however, leads this team in both steals and rebounding. They've got a lot of guys who do a lot of different things.
Here is Rush. He has yet to take a shot. Outside to Jackson. A second try. Chalmers from 3. And a rebound by Darger, who is out of Riverton, Utah. Kansas, 4 possessions and no score.
Curtis Terry, he was the power forward on this team last year, and now he's the point guard. because Lon Kruger really trusts his decision making.
Darger, Rougeau, bumped by Jackson. That is off of Jackson and out of bounds.
It's going to be really difficult for UNLV to get a lot of back to the basket, low post offense. They really don't have a back to the basket scorer. Lon Kruger's guys, however, they want to throw the ball in there to force the defense to collapse and kick it out for threes.
UNLV was in the Sweet 16 a season ago. There was a screen and a long range three by Darger. Rebound pulled down by Chalmers. Look at him snake his way down court. Shoved and hit by Bailey on the play for the Running Rebels. And he picks up a personal foul for UNLV. It's the first time ever.
And UNLV is going to have to really work hard at getting back on defense. The Jayhawks of Kansas get the ball out and get down the court as quickly as any team in the country.
And Shaw has just come in for Rougeau for UNLV. Shaw is a sophomore from Los Angeles, Fairfax High School. Big steal by Darger. Here comes Terry. And ahead it goes to Bailey. Scrambling, back in Dan, and a whistle. Terry picks up the foul. Curtis Terry with his first. He's the one who hit the initial three of the game for UNLV.
The only basket of the game so far. And that was just a tough break. Bailey made a bad pass, and Terry wasn't able to handle it. Bailey, 6 feet five, very long arms. He always guards the opponent's point guard.
Terry is on Chalmers. Pick and roll with Jackson. They keep pounding it inside. Another foul. And that will go on Shaw, who picks up his first, the third on UNLV.
We're talking about the aggressiveness of the UNLV defense. Here's Curtis Terry really getting after him. Now, did they just call a foul on somebody? No. Called a hold on Corey Bailey.
That's his second.
I thought they may have called a technical for a moment, but it's just a holding foul on Corey Bailey.
Robinson to inbound for Kansas. Rush, Jackson, and open two.
That's another thing about Kansas. Those big guys can face the basket shooting the ball.
Here comes Terry, his brother is Jason Terry, the one-time great guard for the Arizona Wildcats. Screen by Shaw. Wink Adams out of Houston. He'll put up a three over Rush. And Jackson sweeps the glass clean.
He may have to try to beat Rush off the dribble. It's going to be hard for Adams at 6 feet to get the ball up over top of Rush.
Oh, Jackson hits again. He's at two in a row, and he's got four, and Kansas has the lead.
Well, you're so concerned about playing off to help out that Jackson gets the ball out there on the perimeter. Now you've become believers. You've got to go out and get him.
A steal. It's Chalmers sailing in. Oh! That'll wake you up.
He did more than sail just there. Put a punctuation mark on that thing. Wow. He and Robinson both very, very good stealing the ball, and UNLV can't afford that.
Explosive Kansas, 6-0 in the last 52 seconds. A Terry triple over Robinson. Rebound is hauled down by Rush, who was so aggressive in that first half the other day against Portland State in round one. Now here is Arthur, doubled off the block. Jackson with the rebound, squeezes the trigger and a foul. Where Jackson has come out so aggressive.
Jackson really has been unbelievable with his aggressiveness. Three-point basket, a two-point basket facing by Jackson, and then he goes and gets the rebound, and here's the steal. This is something UNLV can't afford, but this looks nice for Kansas fans, doesn't it?
Let's go to... Welcoming back our audience. UNLV with 16 fouls, Kansas with none, and Jackson's got 4 points, and he's at the free throw line right now for the Jayhawks, the number four team in the AP poll, the number one seed in the Midwest. They were number one a season ago as well. Bill Self, who played college basketball at Oklahoma State, has stopped at Tulsa and University of Illinois. He's had success wherever he's been. Kansas with their biggest lead of four. Jayhawks keep their starting five on the floor. New player coming in, Kendall Wallace, now for UNLV. Nick Adams has it. He was a highly recruited guard out of Houston. Here's Terry. Rougeau picked up by Jackson, who slips. And that is a foul.
That's actually a break for James.
Well, it is. I know.
Picked
it
up the foul.
That's a foul on him. That is his first. 14:54. It's a play here in the first. Here comes Sasha Khan, a one-time starter now off the bench. And the nice rotation that Bill Self has developed has been really kind of headlined by that right there. By Khan coming in later on, Sharon Collins.
Well, Khan gives them some size and strength on the inside. And that's where they have a big advantage already. So that just adds to the advantage.
Terry drawing the double and slashing off the baseline. It's picked up by Kendall Wallace. Knocked away. Here comes Terrell Arthur. Another steal. Another deuce for the Jayhawks. More points off turnovers.
This UNLV team plays tremendous defense, but there's no defense against something like that. You've got to be able to get back and set your defense. And here they got to get Wink Adams off on this end.
Arthur had the ball knocked out of his hands, and Kansas, a great defensive team, too. Number one in defensive field goal percentage in the Big 12.
It's really tough to throw the ball all the way across the court like that, particularly against a team that moves as well as the Jayhawks.
Sharon Collins has just checked in the game. Robinson is sitting. So it's Collins, who is the sixth man award winner in the rugged Big 12 this season. Coming off a solid game the other day against Portland State, has it with a Khan screen. Rush is picked up by Terry. Sasha Khan. A shot, travel. Well, UNLV scored on their initial possession. They've had nothing since, and they trail by six.
Well, we talked to Lon Kruger yesterday, and we asked him what he thought the keys to the game were, and he said he thought the most important thing for his team to do today was to make some shots. He said, I know we can play defense well enough, but we've got to make some shots.
One of six so far. Here comes Terry. Target picked up on the defensive switch by Arthur. And here's Collins. Screened by Darger. Switch on defense, Terry.
Kansas very conscious of getting out and defending the three-point line.
That's another triple by Terry. Arthur was in his face, and a couple of triples by Curtis Terry.
I think Arthur was surprised that Terry was going to shoot that one. That was a deep, deep three.
About 18,000 others were surprised, too, here in this building. Rush with the slash and the feet inside. Sasha Khan with an offensive rebound. Keeps it alive for the Hawks and gets out of traffic. Chalmers lasers one inside. It's Arthur. What a pass by Mario Chalmers.
Well, and if Kansas is going to attack the offensive boards like that, it's going to be very difficult for UNLV. Their tallest guy out there is Joe Darger, and he's 6 feet six. And none of them, you can take a look at them, none of them are big, bulky guys.
No. He's been basically setting screens as Darger on the perimeter. There's a shove. There is a foul. It'll be on Kansas, and it goes on Sharon Collins, number one.
The key to this whole thing is the ability to get on the offensive board, but what a tremendous pass by Mario Chalmers, threading the needle from the top of the key to Arthur down alone under the basket.
Jackson back in. Arthur will sit. Robinson is back in. Mario Chalmers will take a seat on the Bill Self bench.
Kansas doing a great job pressuring the basketball, daring the guys from UNLV to drive it to the goal.
2-3 so far out there by the Running Rebels. The slashing drive inside by Terry. And he was whacked in foul, trying to force the issue in there. As Kansas picks up the foul. That goes on Khan for the first time.
They're daring him to drive to the basket, and Terry is just the guy to accept that dare. We talked to him yesterday, and he told us that every game he plays, he knows it could be his last game, and he is going to play hard. And certainly you've seen that from him so far in this game today.
We told you before that Terry was a walk-on. He's from University Place, Washington. He, in fact, recruited UNLV. He recruited Lon Kruger and said, I'd love to come play for you in Las Vegas.
Well, he knew Lon Kruger when Lon was the coach at Atlanta, and Lon told us that Curtis Terry used to come by and visit with the Atlanta Hawks, and then Terry didn't get any scholarship offers, and when he read in the paper that Lon Kruger had gotten hired at Nevada Las Vegas, he gave him a call and said, Coach, can I come and walk on? And Lon Kruger said, sure, and he has never regretted the decision.
What a pass by Collins, and flying off the baseline was Sasha Khan. Never broke stride. You know, and Khan puts it in.
They're going to shoot a pretty high percentage if they keep shooting dunks.
Guy that's got it right here, 7 points for Terry. He scored all the points for the Running Rebels so far.
This is a tough matchup for Wink Adams.
Rougeau with the screen. Adams into three defending Jayhawks. Rougeau over Kahn. Jackson wheels in the loose ball. His third rebound outlet caught by Sharon Collins.
Oh, they got Kahn.
Yep, trying to stake his claim inside the lane.
Well, he doesn't need to pop Darger like that. He can get his position inside. That's two now, and Sasha Kahn.
And he will leave, and Arthur will come in when we come back with 11:42 to play. Here in the first half is Robinson, whose calling card is defense. Terry will drive, and that is a foul. It's on Russell Robinson, who is a all-conference defender. Three straight seasons. Picks up his first for Coach Bill Self.
Robinson's calling card is defense, and Terry's calling card is toughness. And that time, Terry just, I mean, he weathered the storm. I think against any other player, Robinson may have had a steal.
Kansas enjoying their biggest lead right now. UNLV had an initial three-point lead to start the game. This is a screen by Rougeau, and they got Rashawn Adams. Darger. And Arthur lets him fire. And Darger's got his first two.
Darger, I think, is going to have to be a big contributor today. Wink Adams is going to have a difficult time shooting the ball over Brandon Rush, and I think that makes Darger all the more important.
Sasha Kahn with a couple fouls, and that's why Arthur is back in the game. That's a jump tie-up.
Joe Darger, we talked about the fact that they don't have any big brutes in there. 6'6", about 220 pounds, but he is a very effective outside shooter. He's got to guard the other team's big guy on defense, but on offense, he wanders around out on the perimeter and can really score.
Wink Adams facing two with the double that left Rougeau open. So they all went to Adams. Rougeau is free to fire for two.
Very concerned about Adams, but Rougeau, he's a guy who's also capable of putting points on the board. He's not a three-point shooter, but that mid-range jump shot, he's very effective.
Rush has not taken a shot today so far. Robinson, Rush over Terry.
Oh! Now, you can't guard that. Terry was in as good a position as he possibly could have been. Rush was so impressive on Thursday.
When he's locked in and focused, he is some kind of player. Now they switch on defense. Here's Adams in a screen. Adams will drive into Arthur. And he gets his own tip to go in. Nice play by Wink Adams with his first two after missing his first two shots.
6 feet tall, gets in, gets it up on the board, and tips it in.
Only returning starter from a season ago. Rush with a deceptive move. And it's picked up by Rougeau. Eighth-seeded UNLV, number one-seeded Kansas. Terry with a three, and Rush with his second rebound.
Now, you don't want to get into a running up and down game with Kansas, but that was a good effort by Terry. He's already knocked down a couple of three-point shots. That one was wide open.
Screen by Arthur. Collins. Jackson. It's picked up by Adams. And a three-on-one. I think Robinson may have knocked it away, but knocked it in the rim. Nonetheless, they give Adams the basket. He's hit two in a row. And down by six, UNLV has come back to tie.
They are so scrappy and tough on defense, and they can really create some havoc.
It's an 8-2 run by the Running Rebels. Rush, another creep move to get that free shot. Down it goes! Rush is in two of his last three.
Now, Wink Adams has to stay on the floor at 6 feet tall. He's not going to block the shot by Brandon Rush. He's got to stay in front of him, get his hand up in his face. Bill Self wanting to know why that wasn't a three.
Rush has four, Jackson has five, Darrell Arthur has four.
And the officials just told him it wasn't a three because it was inside the line.
Adams into Rush. Robinson tried to poke it away. Look at Adams weaving his way through traffic in a foul. He is so quick and so fast, and that is a Kansas foul.
Well, Adams said also his strength is something to be considered. Takes the ball in, and I think you're right. Robinson hit it first, then Rush hit it, and it went in the basket. But here Rush with the answer. What a great move. That fake, then just a one dribble moves to the side, wide open, knocks it down.
Brandon Rush has picked up his first personal foul for Kansas. And here is Wink Adams at the free throw line, a big playmaker in that championship game of the Mountain West Tournament, 23 points against ranked BYU. And he was the Mountain West Conference Tournament MVP as freshman Cole Aldrich will come in.
And Adams is a young man who gets to the free throw line. You can see his percentages on the year, but that was his 162nd free throw attempt of the year, so he goes to the line.
The freshman Aldrich comes in for Darnell Jackson. Chalmers will come in for Brandon Rush. 22 to play here in the first half.
And Adams may not be able to get the ball all the way to the basket, although we've seen him do it with that size in there, but he certainly can draw fouls.
Look for moisture on the floor. Free throw shooting so far, UNLV 2 of 3, Kansas 1 of 2.
This can tend to be a little bit distracting for the free throw shooter. He's got to stand there and watch this going on.
Well, there's no ice on the floor, and sometimes you didn't find condensation because of the cool underbelly of the court, but that's not the case here. We're on concrete, and it's comfortable temperature inside. UNLV has 10 points off turnovers already. In fact, 10 of their first 15.
Well, their defense is their calling card, and in this game, I think it's more important than maybe in any of the other game all season long that they have to create offense with that pressure defense.
Adams, an 84% free throw shooter, and number 2 in the Mountain West Conference.
And how long did he stand there, Kevin? He made the first free throw, then was forced to stand there, and it just made no difference. He went up and knocked it down.
Mauricio Rutledge, a junior from Sacramento, will check in for the Running Rebels. Adams at the line moments ago as the last 6 points for UNLV. We're tied again. Kansas is led by 6. The Rebels had an initial 3-0 lead. Robinson, Sharon Collins picked up by Wallace.
Really trying to put pressure on the ball.
8 to play in the first half. It's Terrell Arthur over Rujo. Through the hands of Cole Aldrich, the diving Wallace vacuumed in by Rutledge, who meets the defense of Collins. Rujo into Aldrich with a fake, a drive. He'll go to the line. Cole Aldrich will pick up his first. We've got a timeout and 7:48 to play in the first half from Omaha. Coming up at halftime from our studios in New York, Greg Clark and Seth with live look-ins and tournament news and the AT&T Naismith Watch at the AT&T at the half. It's next on CBS, Kevin Harlan, Dan Bonner, Omaha, Nebraska. The winner goes to the Sweet 16. That's where UNLV was a season ago. Kansas made it to the regional finals and lost to UCLA. At the line, Rujo. And it looks like UNLV has weathered that early storm when Kansas can really pack some power.
Well, that's right. Kansas can, they're one of those teams that can hit you with the run and knock you out of the game, and UNLV took that blow, and now they lead by 2. It's become sort of a scrappy half-court defensive game, and that's what UNLV wants.
The Running Rebels on a 12-4 run. They trail 13-7. Got Robinson and Chalmers in there. Rutledge watches the ultra quick. Chalmers take it down the lane. Knocked out of bounds. Shot clock at 21.
Juan Kruger, his guys have done such a great job defending the three-point field goal. Kansas does not have a three-point field goal yet today.
It's Rush over 3 defenders. It's picked up by Rutledge and off his hands and out of bounds. So Rush has started this game 2 of 4. With 4 points, Jackson with 5, 4 for Arthur, 6 points for Wink Adams, and 7 for Curtis Terry of UNLV. Screens, a double one, sets up Chalmers, missing the 3 and picked up by Wink Adams.
What a great block out by Adams. He had Brandon Rush on his back and was able to get that rebound.
UNLV started this game 2 of 9. They've gone 4 of 5 since. Got a couple threes, Kansas with none so far. Wink Adams and rushes on him. Shaw the screen, the double on Adams. Shaw left open for the triple. Rebounded by Rutledge, he gets it over Chalmers and knocked away by Terrell Arthur. And here comes Mario Chalmers the other way.
Might be better advised on that play to throw it outside.
High low, Arthur to Cole Aldrich, who's the player of the year out of Minnesota.
That's where Kansas has an advantage in there. Aldrich, 6'11", nobody even close for UNLV. That was a great pass and catch.
Screen by Shaw. Terry picked up by Robinson. Aldridge comes out on Shaw. Now they switch on defense. Shaw into the freshman Aldridge. And a foul.
We've been talking about Wink Adams and his offensive play, but sometimes you got to do the job defensively. Even though he's a guard, he goes back and he blocks out against Brandon Rush. But Kansas with a huge size advantage, making use of it right there.
So here is Matt Shaw at the free throw line, a guy who originally signed to play at Temple. They had a coaching change. He opted out. He's from Los Angeles. He chose UNLV. And drains his first. Kansas with a couple players to keep track of foul-wise. Kahn's got two. Aldridge has two fouls. Here comes Darnell Jackson.
Isn't it interesting, though, Bill Self's substitute big guys both have picked up two fouls.
Yes.
His starters are not in that situation, but UNLV has created that situation by driving the ball to the basket.
UNLV is plus 6 points at the free throw line over the Jayhawks. 6:26 to play here in the first half. Darger will come in. Shaw will sit. So Kansas will face the full court. Robinson gets it from Rush. Also out there, Chalmers, Jackson, and Arthur. For UNLV, they've got Rutledge and Terry and Darger. Rougeau and Wink Adams. A screen by Jackson. The drive by Robinson with the left hand. Count it for two and a foul. Russell Robinson pushes the issue inside.
Robinson so quick, and UNLV's been utilizing the ball driving to the basket, and that's a situation where Darger, he's not going to block the shot. He's just got to step out of the way, but Robinson so quick attacking the goal.
So Darger picks up his first, and here is Russell Robinson at the free throw line. On full court pressure. Talk about the scope of Kansas's recruiting. They got one starting guard from Alaska, the other one from New York City, Robinson. How about that? That's covering every inch of the country.
Bring them together in the middle of the country.
It's Darger over Arthur. A three. The rebound by Rush, who is a three-time first-team Big 12 All-Selection. Adams is on Robinson. Screened by Jackson. Lost it. Intercepted by Mauricio Rutledge. And here comes Darger.
And what a nice play by Chalmers to make them stop. So no fast break.
Terry a three. Teeing one up again. He's already knocked down a couple of good-looking rebounds by Jackson. He's got four rebounds. Chalmers from the wing, slashing inside. Oh, is he fast? He's now got four. And Kansas up by three.
But now this is, Kevin, another one of those points in the game. The crowd is into it now. UNLV, they're not going to make all their shots, but this is one of those points in the game where they have to make one.
That's a good point, the switch on defense. Over Chalmers, it's Adams. The rebound by Rougeau. The interception by Russell Robinson. Under five to play in the first half. As UNLV has not hit anything from the field in 4 minutes and 15 seconds. Chalmers again. These Kansas guards are unstoppable. Except right there. Wipe it away. That offensive foul. Chalmers number one. But boy, they are attacking on every possession.
Well, I think Bill Self at that last timeout decided they were going to attack the basket because that's where they can have some success. Chalmers charged first time, basket that time.
Kansas plus 10 points in the paint.
There are no shot blockers in the game for UNLV.
Darger got a screen from Terry, and he drives on the taller Arthur. Rutledge can't hit it. They volleyball it around. Claimed by the newly instated Collins, a two-on-one with Rush. And UNLV fills in the cracks and gets back on defense.
That was a great job by the running Rebels to run back on defense.
Rush over Darger. And Brandon Rush has gone 3 of 5.
And Jackson is down.
7-0 run by Kansas at 4:15 of this first half in a predominantly Kansas crowd. Very quiet as Jackson, who probably has improved as much as any single player in college basketball this year, gets up slowly.
Well, he certainly has become a force for Bill Self. And now Bill Self is asking Jackson if he's okay, because remember, Sasha Kahn and Cole Aldridge both have two personal fouls.
Good point.
Boy, Kansas has really turned up the intensity both on offense and on defense. UNLV just really struggling right at the moment.
And they're 6 of 20 from the field on the running Rebels, 30%. Kansas at 57% from the floor. You just saw nothing from the field last seven possessions. It's Terry. Now Wink Adams. Chalmers on him. The Rougeau screen. The mismatch against Jackson, who now fills in, and Rougeau into Darnell. Jackson again claims it. He has ruined the class, and Rougeau picks up a foul. Jackson gets his fifth rebound.
When UNLV made their run, they were getting fouled, but now Kansas playing good defense without fouling, and as a result, the Jayhawks lead it by five.
In a game that has contained four ties and three lead changes, UNLV has been up by as many as three. Kansas has led by as many as six. Right now, UNLV has scored six more points than the Hawks above the three-point arc. They have scored five more points at the free throw line, but Kansas plus 10 points in the paint.
Kansas has been attacking the basket. A lot of those points in the paint are drives.
NCAA March Madness Central, powered by the first ever Pontiac G8, is your home for live look-ins and game highlights and more all day throughout the tournament. Check it out on CBS College Sports Network. Jackson has six with five rebounds. Rougeau.
The Kansas on-the-ball defense has really been solid since UNLV was able to get back and take that two-point lead.
The double on Wallace. The feed into Rougeau, who dances into a double there. Targer with a three, and he puts it in now, plus 9 points above the arc for UNLV.
And that was a nice job. Rougeau, not a back-to-the-basket player, but Kansas went down and double-teamed him, and Darger, dangerous outside shooter, knocks one down. Only 3 for 11, though, from beyond the arc.
Here's Collins, snaps it outside, a three by Chalmers, missed it all. Kansas, before that, missed it at four consecutive shots. Yeah, smart play by UNLV's offense.
Well, the double team comes inside and Darger's wide open. It's a nice job by Darger to find the open spot. And then the UNLV guys, they really do a nice job looking for one another.
Kansas downsizes. Robinson is back in with Collins and Chalmers, and they take out Darnell Jackson.
And even doing that, they're still bigger than UNLV.
Yeah, true. Away from the ball, there's a foul. And that goes on Robinson, who picks up number two. So he's got two. Kahn has two. Aldridge has two for Kansas.
And Bill Self, his reaction is understandable. His team just is not really able to get into any kind of a rhythm. And they expected that that would be difficult against the defense played by UNLV. But you don't want to be putting these guys on the free throw line. They shoot almost 75% as a team.
Now from the free throw line, UNLV has gone 8 of 9. Kansas, 3 of 5.
Well, nice little spurt here by UNLV after, once again, it looked like Kansas was going to stretch it out.
Kansas has not hit a three yet. In comes Corey Bailey, a 27-year-old senior from Tampa, Florida. He's the guy that we talked about earlier, was the one-time air conditioning repairman who started tonight's game.
Well, this is really funny. Bailey came in the game and Terry went out, and Lon Kruger does not want Terry out of the game. He had the official stop and say, no, that's not the guy I wanted out of the game. And so Rougeau came out and Terry's back in.
He plays virtually every minute for the running Rebels. Collins screened by Arthur.
That's just how much confidence Lon Kruger has in Curtis Terry. Now Bailey's got two fouls.
Russell Robinson is picked up on the perimeter by Kendall Wallace. A screen by Arthur to look for the pick and roll. That means Robinson's open.
Great block out by Bailey.
Kansas screens about as much as any team in college basketball.
Well, they do a great job moving without the ball. You have to be able to guard guys who can dribble. You've got to guard screens.
Three three-point hits by UNLV. None so far for Kansas. That has kept the ball in the hands of UNLV, and it's a one-point game because of it. And they're hitting the free throws as well, and getting to the line are the running Rebels.
Well, the free throws have been the key so far.
Switch on defense. They now have Arthur on Terry. The shot clock at two. The slash inside. The defense by Arthur, and a shot clock violation on UNLV.
And Curtis Terry is telling Joe Darger, hey, get out of the way. Get to the corner. I'm going to drive the ball to the basket. You go to the corner. I'll throw it to you. But Darger just stood there and allowed Terry to be double-teamed. Watch it. Get to the corner. That's exactly what he said. Get to the corner.
Darnell Jackson will come back in the game.
And that's why Lon Kruger wants that young man in the game. He is out there directing traffic, and he's displaying tremendous intensity while doing it.
Terrell Arthur will sit for Kansas. Coaching a minute and a half to play in the first half. The guards, Robinson, Collins, and Chalmers. The drive by Russell Robinson. Chalmers with the three. Good! Russell Robinson gave the feed. And Chalmers knocks down Kansas's first three. Mario Chalmers has seven. That's the leading score for KU. Timeout UNLV. Kansas is shooting 54%. 30% for the Runnin' Rebels, who trail by four. Russell Robinson with his six assists. Watch this play.
And here, Chalmers is going to go to the corner, and then Robinson is going to drive and make the diving pass. And Chalmers knocks it down.
Jeremy Caves has checked in for the Kansas Jayhawks with Rush. Jackson, who's had a solid first half. Chalmers and Sharon Collins is on Terry.
Well, now I think it's very important for the Rebs here to not allow Kansas to get a little spurt before the half.
Kendall Wallace a three.
Ah, Dargard over the back. That's not a good foul because that'll send Kansas to the line for a couple of free throws.
Dargard picks up his second. UNLV just one field goal the last 8 minutes, yet they only trail by four. So they've been able to stick in there, hitting three-point shots and their free throws. Look at Lon Kruger, one-time coach at Kansas State. Went to Illinois and won, and before that went to Florida and won, went to the NBA and lost, and now he's back in the college ranks where he feels comfortable. Last year he coached his son, and he had all those senior starters, and they made the Sweet 16. Here's Darnell Jackson. Third team Big 12 selection. Hits it right there. Jackson from the line today, 3 of 5. 7 points and 6 rebounds. Hawks have led by as many as 6, and UNLV has led up by as many as 3.
And there's that 6-point lead again, and this is what great teams like Kansas do to you. You hang in the game and hang in the game, and then they throw a spurt at you right before halftime. Very important last minute for UNLV.
It's Corey Bailey. Inside for Wink Adams. What a pitch from Bailey. And Adams has his 8th. First half point, and Bill Self is livid on a backdoor pass. The Rebels to within 4 of Mighty KU. 9th play here by Corey Bailey of the Runnin' Rebels.
Well, you don't need to be denying Wink Adams the ball at that point in the game. Make him work against the defense.
Jeremy Cain stays on the floor for the Kansas Jayhawks. Back there with Collins and Mario Chalmers. They've got Arthur and Rush up front. Here comes Sharon Collins, a sophomore from Chicago, Illinois. The drive by Chalmers and the floater.
Wow.
Chalmers just hit a 3, and now he puts up a running 2, and he's got 9.
And not only that, Kevin, they scored. They'll get the ball back again in all probability. That was a quick 2. Now they've got to get it done on the defensive end.
Kansas has equaled their biggest lead today. Wink Adams.
Boy, he has just not had any room for that step back 3-point jump shot.
Suffocating Kansas defense on the perimeter at times. Now they got Arthur on him with the defensive switch. Chalmers is on Shaw. Shot clock is down to 5. Terry will get the screen. And over Chalmers. Picked up by Bailey with an offensive rebound. And by Shaw. Knocked away by Arthur. Who picks up the Kansas foul? Or do they go? Yep, it is Arthur who picks it up. Number 1 on Durrell.
Boy, Curtis Terry with an extremely difficult shot. Well defended, but there's Bailey inside. Defender fell down, and he just missed the shot, and Shaw's there. Not a lot of work on the offensive boards in the first half by UNLV, but a key offensive rebound in that situation.
Let's take a few steps back here and take a look at what you've seen in this first half by both teams.
Well, I think it's the scrambling pressure UNLV defense and their ability to get to the free throw line that has kept them in this game.
And what about KU?
Now, Kansas, I think, has been a little herky-jerky, and I think you've got to give some of the credit to that to UNLV. Kansas tried to go inside with the pass early in the game. As the half went on, they started driving the ball to the basket and had more success. I think we'll see more of that in the second half.
Jackson is in. Jeremy Keynes will check out for the Kansas Jayhawks. Picked up by Arthur. Final seconds. Can they get a shot away? Collins, good if it goes. That takes us to halftime. This may surprise some people. Eighth seed UNLV down by five to number one seed Kansas at halftime. It sends you to Greg Gumbel with the AT&T at the half after this message. Watching CBS Sports, home of the men's NCAA basketball championship. Every time UNLV has come close, Kansas has rattled off runs of 9-0, 8-0, and 7-2. Watching tonight's game in HD TV, brought to you by HP. Here's our in-game box score now, powered by CBS College Sports Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports. This gives us a chance to thank our Cam Howie. After 10 great years at CBS, he is off to enter the banking business in London. Safe travels, my friend, and thank you for a terrific decade at CBS Sports. With Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan, our producer, Craig Silver, our director, Andy Goldberg, and 50 other great professionals bringing you this tournament from Omaha and points around the country. Kansas has led by as many as six, and they trailed initially 3-0 to UNLV.
Very interesting first half. The running Rebels of UNLV shot lower than 30%, 29.6, only 23% from beyond the arc, and yet somehow they are within 5 points of the Jayhawks of Kansas.
Robinson begins things. Jackson has it on top. Arthur is screen. Robinson will work on Corey Bailey. Screened by Arthur. Chalmers. Here is Rush, who has started 3 of 5. Down the lane with the alley-oop, and it's pounded in by Terrell Arthur.
Kansas had tremendous success driving the ball to the basket in the first half, and they start out that way here in the second half. Nice drive by Rush. Excellent pass and finish.
Jayhawks have their biggest lead. Adams into two, defending Kansas players, comes up with his 10th point. The other way, Rush in a hurry, putting up a three. Brandon Rush, he's got 9.
And danger time for UNLV. Kansas looking very sharp coming out of the locker room.
There's a shove and a foul on UNLV. Darger setting a screen. Darger picks up number 3.
Rush drives to the basket. Darnell Jackson is the guy who set the screen, and he just rolls to the basket, circles around, and Rush finds him. And now Darger picks up that foul. That's his third personal foul. Darger, a very important player offensively, had 5 in the first half. They can ill afford to have him sitting on the bench.
Rush again, another screen. This time Jackson sets it for Robinson, who is 1 of 1. It's Arthur against the smaller Darger, knocked away inside, and a foul. And it will go on Rene Rougeau. Rancho Cucamonga, California. It's the third on Rene. Running Rebels have won 5 consecutive games and 8 of 9. Overall record of 27-7. From the Mountain West Conference, the Mountain West champions in the tournament. And Terrell Arthur at the free throw line, the leading scorer for Kansas this season, the second in rebounding, and the top shot blocker.
And he's had to wait there for a second or two at the free throw line because Darnell Jackson got, I think, got hit in the mouth.
I agree.
And it took Jackson a while to get himself set.
Kansas coming in has won 8 consecutive games. The number one scoring margin team in college basketball. They average winning 20 points a game. Phenomenal reach.
Well, and people talk about their offense, but they play so well on the defensive end, coming in holding their opponents to only 38% shooting, and they've done much better than that in the ball game today.
Chalmers is on Adams with a 2. Chalmers alters the shot. The rebound by Rush, racing the other way, met by the defense of Terry.
Adams has just had no room for that jump shot.
And Arthur was spinning and lost the ball. UNLV with the ball. Do they still have the cachet that name UNLV in college basketball?
Yeah, they sure do. And, you know, we talked to Lon Kruger about that, and he said there are people in Las Vegas are serious about their basketball, and certainly the Sweet 16 run last year didn't hurt anything.
That's where all those high school and AAU tournaments are, too, in Vegas. Here's Adams dancing. Rougeau lost it. A turnover. That is the seventh UNLV turnover. And that kind of tells you about what was and what is. You just saw Larry Johnson, who played for those Final Four teams at UNLV under Jerry Tarkanian. Arthur on top and Rougeau on him. Chalmers looking for Jackson. Sets the screen. Robinson there into Darger. It's Jackson plowing inside. And picked up by Rougeau.
That was good defense without fouling by Darger, who's got three personal fouls. UNLV really needs a basket.
And Terry tries to get it. Wink Adams outside. Rougeau screen, a switch on defense. The slashing Adams and a foul on Kansas. Went up against the big men down low. And the foul will go on Darnell Jackson for the second time.
We talked about Adams and his inability to get anything going from the outside, but he's been very effective driving ball to the basket and getting himself to the free throw line.
Adams, when he came out of Houston, Texas, was the number two rated point guard in high school basketball. His team won three consecutive Texas private school championships. He is a junior out of Houston. Averages 16 a game, and tonight he's got 11. From the line, 3 of 3. Jackson snares another rebound, number 7 for him.
Calling card for UNLV all season long has been their defense, and they've got to turn up the defensive pressure now.
3 minutes gone here in the second half. Wheeling is Robinson. Jackson is screen. Terry fighting through it, and the drive by Russell Robinson.
It's just so hard. If the Kansas guards are going to get by out on the perimeter, you're guarding a big guy. It's just your temp. You just can't leave because they'll throw the ball for the dunk.
Robinson's got 5. And here is Bailey grinding against Rush. Chalmers, one-time co-defensive player of the Big 12, is in defending. Adams snaps it outside. Darger for 3. He's hit another one. He's got 8. His second triple tonight.
Boy, that's a big basket.
A 3 outside. Robinson can't nail it. And a whistle and a foul. That will go inside. Looked like maybe Jarrell Arthur picked it up. He did. That is number 2 on Arthur.
And Kansas with so many offensive weapons. Here's Robinson driving to the basket. You can see the defense sort of parts. Who in the heck do you guard? Well, one of the guys that Kansas should guard is Joe Darger. We mentioned he is an excellent three-point shooter, and particularly when UNLV can get that dribble penetration, if he can spot up, he can get some points.
Kansas can't shake free. Adams inside. Terry had the mismatch working on Robinson. They lost it out of bounds. Another turnover. 8 turnovers by the Running Rebels. 3 in this half. Talk about balance.
Yeah, talk about balance. 6 players have scored 20-plus points in a game this season. And I'm not so sure that all of those guys, everyone who scored 20, I'm not so sure that in an individual game they wouldn't be capable of getting 30. So it really does leave you in a quandary.
Robinson is out. Darrell Arthur is out. Sasha Khan playing with a couple of early fouls in the first half is in for the first time in a long time. And Sharon Collins has come in the backcourt for Kansas. Terry watches Chalmers. And Bailey is on Collins. Khan works on Darger. A lot of room to operate.
Just nothing Darger can do. Khan did a great job getting position very close to the basket. Darger simply not big enough to push him off the block.
Sasha's got 4. Kansas 58% shooting in this game, 33% for UNLV. Rougeau to Bailey, picked up by Jackson and across the lane. Darger outside.
Now Darger was in his spot, but Bailey was not able to make a very good pass.
With the shot clock down to 6. They got Khan on Terry. Mismatch. Darger over Collins. And a great play defensively by KU. But Sharon throws it away and Rougeau comes up with it. And about 5 minutes gone here in the second half. Screen by Rougeau. a wink at him's three. And a rebound by Chalmers. They break it with a two-on-one. Rush on one side. Back on defense, UNLV, a triple. Rushes off. And Brandon has gone 4 of 7. He's got 9. He leads the Jayhawks in scoring. 11 by Adams leads everybody in this game. Rougeau. Adams. Kahn defending.
Rougeau. That was nice defense by Kahn.
Like an accordion, back and forth, kind of stretching his way, and Adams inside puts up a prayer, and he's fouled. Across the lane, a foul. And that is going to go on Sasha Kahn for a third time. That is a developing story for Kansas, leading by 9 in the second half. Kansas Jayhawks are plus 14 points in the paint. They've out-rebounded UNLV by 5, but UNLV has scored 6 more points above the arc and 5 more points at the free throw line.
UNLV has not shot the ball well from outside the arc, Kevin. They're only shooting 3 of 13, but they have made 3 3-point field goals. They've defended Kansas very well from beyond the arc. The Jayhawks only with 1, and Wink Adams once again gets inside and gets to the line.
Adams 3 of 4 from the stripe. He's got a game high 11. Kansas has balanced scoring, as their history shows. Chalmers with 9, 9 for Rush, 7 for Arthur, 8 for Darnell Jackson. Only player in foul trouble right now. They took that foul away from Kahn and they gave it to Brandon Rush. That was during the break. The officials went over to the official scoring table and changed the call after looking at it. A little full court pressure here by the running Rebels, who have trailed by as many as 10 and led by as many as 3 against number 1 seed Kansas. Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan, here is Sharon Collins. Screened by Kahn. Terry is all over Chalmers. Here's Rush. He's gone 4 of 7. Shot clock is down to 7. 6 minutes gone in the half. Whistle. And a timeout.
Sharon Collins called the timeout.
Heady player, smart player for Coach Bill Self. 13:58 to play. Kansas trying to go to the Sweet 16, taking on UNLV earlier tonight. Wisconsin took care of Kansas State. 5 in the shot clock. Collins takes it down the lane with a sweet left-handed layup. The slashing Sharon Collins has got 2.
And that's the benefit of that timeout. Collins took the timeout. They were able to organize a play.
It's Darger left free. Chalmers was sucked to the middle, but it didn't go in. Rougeau with the offensive rebound and a Kahn foul. It looked like inside for the Kansas Jayhawks. Sasha picks up number 3. And he is the only player from the Jayhawks with 3. There are 2 with 3. From UNLV. Darger has got 3. Rougeau has 3. Darger. Corey Bailey. Darger. Guarded by Arthur. Say that 3 times fast. UNLV shooting 30%.
Boy, Kansas' defense has just been
good.
Outstanding.
Just tighten the screws. Adams fouled by Chalmers. Second on Mario. Kansas at 57% from the floor tonight. And they say it's impossible for an underdog to go the distance. Then again, they said it's impossible to get real Coke taste and 0 calories. Log on to mycokerewards.com and get lots of great NCAA gear. Wink Adams at the line. The Wisconsin Badgers are the team that took care of Kansas State earlier tonight here in Omaha. 72-55, and they are watching. Are they on a collision course with the Jayhawks? Last year, Wisconsin was knocked out in the first round by Ron Kruger and the Running Rebels, who made the Sweet 16. This is the 11th NCAA appearance for Kruger. 3 different schools. Terrific coach.
He's got, not only does he make appearances, he's got multiple wins in the NCAA tournament with all those schools.
UNLV staying tight, and coming in now will be Matt Shaw. Darger will take a breather. So it's Terry, Bailey, Shaw, Rougeau in the game, and Wink Adams. That's the Running Rebel 5.
And they are hanging around and hanging around. One thing that Kansas has done very well is avoid turnovers. This UNLV team forces a lot of them.
Rushes 4 of 8. Jackson tries to tip it in. Out of bounds it goes. It's off of UNLV. Kansas out there with Arthur and Jackson. Collins, Rush, and Mario Chalmers. Bill Self, 10th consecutive season, he's taken a team to the NCAA tournament. Terrion Collins. Look at him dance down low. Draw the double.
Boy, Terry just doesn't quit, though, does he?
No.
He just keeps going at it.
What a motor. Jackson a screen. Chalmers slides it inside to the double team, Darrell Arthur. Terry with the rebound. That's his second. Darrell Arthur has gone 3 of 6. He's got 7 points and a couple rebounds.
UNLV doing a nice job on the defensive end, but the problem is, for the most part in this game, they've had to play against the set half-court defense of the Jayhawks, and that's been tough.
Wink Adams right in the rush, and that is a foul on KU. Rugged play, Jackson takes it inside, and Darnell Jackson will pick up number 3, becoming the second player from Kansas with 3.
Well, and Adams just, he puts his head down, and he goes to the basket. And he forced that foul because he sort of was sliding to his left, was Wink Adams, and Jackson tried to move to maintain his position and just never got there.
At the free throw line is Adams. He is 7 of 8. So for the audience that has just joined us, tell us why UNLV is sticking with number 1 seed Kansas.
UNLV is hanging in because they've been able to attack off the dribble and basically get to the free throw line. They have not shot the ball well. They've done a nice job limiting Kansas's offensive rebounding opportunities, but Lon Kruger's guys have just gone out and played extremely hard. And this guy right here, Wink Adams, hasn't been very successful from the field, but he's getting to the free throw line.
Jackson and Chalmers will check out. Russell Robinson is back in the game for Kansas, as is Sasha Khan. Robinson, Collins. Bailey on him, and Arthur screamed. That is a foul. Did Bailey pick it up? I think he did. Yep. The senior for UNLV picks up number 3.
UNLV excellent defensively in defending the 3, and Kansas only 2 for 9. They have struggled from out there. This UNLV, they play with such intensity, they get you going just a step too fast, and sometimes when you hustle that 3-point shot up there, you don't get very good results.
Collins drew the double. 8 minutes gone here in the second half. The drive by Robinson right into the teeth of the defense of Shaw. They'll go to the line as we swing you to our studios in New York and Greg Gumbel. Robinson at the free throw line for the Kansas Jayhawks. They've been outscored there by 11 tonight.
But Kevin, the interesting little feature about that particular stat is that when Kansas has driven the ball to the basket, they have been able to draw fouls and get to the line. A lot of foul trouble out there for the running Rebels. It's just really difficult to make your cuts and passes.
Kansas shooting 53%. Khan was mauled inside. That is a UNLV foul. It may be on Shaw, who is in there defending, and he picks up his 4th foul. He has the most fouls of any player in the game so far.
And Shaw, you know, he's the one big guy possessed by Lon Kruger and the running Rebels. 6'8", 240 pounds, but he has really struggled all day. The whistle has found him.
Darter is checked in for UNLV, taking the place of Shaw. Sharon Collins. He's gone 1 of 2. Collins has 4. He's hit his last 2 shots.
And now we're at another point in the game where it seems like we've been 4 or 5 times where UNLV.
Let's get you back now. Let's get you back to Omaha, UNLV in Kansas.
Adams went 1-2 for UNLV at the free throw line while you were away. And under 11 to play.
That's been the UNLV offense, particularly here in the second half, getting to the free throw line.
No one on Chalmers. Arthur had it, lost it as he came down. Terrell Arthur has grabbed 4 rebounds tonight with 7 points. Leading rebounder is Darnell Jackson with 7. A couple Kansas players with 9. Chalmers and Rush. 18 points for Wink Adams. 10 of those 18 at the free throw stripe. It's Terry to Bailey to Darger. Adams fouled. Nope, it's a UNLV foul. It's on Darger, who picks up number 4. NCAA March Madness on Demand is streaming every game from the NCAA Championship online for free. You can watch any game anytime at the new NCAA.com. Arthur is screened. Rush finds the open door and wide open on the wing. Russell Robinson hits the triple. That is his first 3 tonight. And he's got 10. The first Kansas player in double figures. Every night it seems like it's another player for KU. UNLV has only scored 1 field goal the last 9.5 minutes. Adams over Arthur. Nice rebound by Rush. Picked up by Robinson. Collins into Terry. Robinson goes up high and down hard, and a foul on UNLV.
Kansas has struggled from the three-point line today, but that time Brandon Rush draws 4 defenders, and Robinson left all alone.
Darger has just fouled out with his 5th personal foul for UNLV. He is gone. With 8 points, the starter, a guy who they rely on a lot to do a lot of things for this team, but Darger is out.
And particularly, Kevin, with them trailing in the game by 11, Darger is a long-range shooter, and so they will miss that offense. UNLV's done a nice job defensively, but they just have not been able to score against what has been an outstanding half-court defensive display by the Jayhawks of Kansas. Darger had a couple of tough calls against him. 2 illegal screen calls. And you can see he's upset on the bench.
Darger, in that Run and Rebel win over Kent State on Thursday, he had 18 points. But tonight, just 8. So Russell Robinson at the free throw line for the University of Kansas. 4th all time in Kansas steals. That's where he makes his mark. But tonight, for Kansas, he has put in 10. He averages 8 a game.
Well, once again, he and Chalmers have done a nice job taking care of the basketball. UNLV, a team that has forced 142 more turnovers than they've committed, and that's a big part of their offense, and Kansas has just denied that to them today.
Every time that UNLV has crept closer to the Jayhawks, Kansas has come back with the run. Now, an 8-1 run for KU. Shaw got a screen from Bailey. And that is a Kansas foul. That goes on Darrell Arthur for the 3rd time as former K-State coach Bob Huggins, now with West Virginia, advancing to the Sweet 16. Duke again was wiped out by the Mountaineers.
That's the 2nd year in a row that Duke has not advanced to the Sweet 16.
Lost last year to VCU.
In the first round.
Yes, they did. Bailey at the line. Corey Bailey, a junior college transfer from Butler Community College. He's out of Tampa, Florida.
And as we mentioned about Bailey, he coming out of high school, his grades were not good enough to get into college, and he went and spent 3 years working as an air conditioning repairman, and then ran into some trouble and decided he had better go back to school and went to junior college, and he is actually going to get a degree from UNLV, so it's a real success story.
Screen by Arthur, and here comes Sharon Collins right down the lane. He's got 6. The Kansas guards have been terrific tonight. Hawks have their biggest lead of 13.
And Curtis Terry has not taken a shot yet in this second half. And they're really going to need some offense from him, particularly with Darger out of the game. But it's just hard to get anything against this defense.
Suffocated. Shaw gets his own miss. Couple tries. And that is a foul. It's on the Jayhawks as they continue to grind and dig to these running rebels of UNLV.
Well, we just saw Sharon Collins drive into the lane with a little jump shot. This time, again, he just takes that big body of his, strong young man, and gets all the way to the goal.
And Chalmers picks up his third personal foul, and this will be Matt Shaw at the free throw line.
You know, Collins, he's only 5 feet 11, but he is 205 pounds, and it doesn't look like any of that 205 is fat. You know, he is really, really strong.
And he battles his weight a little bit. This is a kid who is a terrific high school football player in Chicago, a great baseball pitcher, recruited in three different sports.
Wow.
And ends up playing for the revered Kansas basketball program. 8.5 to play.
But now UNLV's got to get some stops.
Look at Robinson right down the lane again, slashing Kansas guards.
And that's where Kansas has had their best success here in the second half, the guards. And there's three of them in the game now. Collins and Robinson and Chalmers just taking the ball and wheeling into the lane to score.
Robinson has 13 a game high. Collins has 6 for Kansas. Rougeau guarded by Rush. Rebounded inside with authority by Darnell Jackson, who claims his 8th rebound for the Jayhawks. Under 8 to play. Screened by Jackson. Collins will get another screen. And Tribe, oh my goodness! Did you see that move by Sharon Collins? Oh my goodness, what a play! He's just given the Jayhawks their biggest lead tonight.
Kevin, we've talked about these guys getting to the basket. He keeps his dribble, fakes one way, goes the other. A fabulous move by Sharon Collins. Get another look at it right here, right through that defense. And Russell Robinson has been doing the same thing. Again, just slashing right through that defense. It's very, very difficult. There's no shot blockers inside for UNLV, and Collins' reaction, yeah, that's a pretty good move.
Robinson with 13, Chalmers with 9, Collins with 8. All part of a 14-3 run by the Jayhawks. And on the other side, the defense has been there, strangling the UNLV offense with nothing from the field for the Running Rebels in almost 9 minutes of this game.
UNLV does not have any type of a back-to-the-basket inside presence. They create a lot of their offense by taking the ball, driving it to the basket, but it's hard to do that against this Kansas team.
Adams the backdoor. What a nice feed on top by Rougeau. And Adams has put in 20. Terrific play. Timeout taken. Let's go to Greg Gumbel.
All right, thank you, Kevin. Timeout in Omaha. Meanwhile, in with the basketball. We'll get you back right now. Let's go back to Omaha, Kevin and Dan.
Kansas Jayhawks, the number one seed here in the Midwest, have been pounding it inside against this much smaller UNLV team. Plus 22 points in the paint for KU over the Rebels. And their bench has outscored the bench of UNLV by 10.
Kevin, it's interesting. They're getting it done inside, but it's not with their big guys. It's their guards driving the ball to the basket. Wink Adams, he's been doing that for UNLV. You can see he's got 20 points there, 10 of them coming on the free throw line.
Robinson with 13 leading Kansas, and now 21 points for Wink Adams for UNLV.
UNLV in this game has only 11 field goals.
The season low is 16. Kansas in control. We'll send you back to Greg Gumbel.
All right, Kevin, seconds remaining in overtime. We'll keep you updated. Back to Omaha.
I guess he got tired of just driving in and laying it up. He was going to do something else.
A little more dramatic about things, didn't he? While you're away, a big-time drive by Chalmers who tried to finish it by putting down a sledgehammer on a dunk, but he missed it. Ricocheted off the rim. He was fouled on the play. Rougeau picked up his 4th at the free throw line. Mario Chalmers.
And this is what we're talking about. Again and again, we've seen the Kansas guards drive into the lane.
Now Chalmers has 10. 13 from Robinson. Collins has 8. 10 from Mario. Adams around the screen of Shaw, who tees up a 3. Picked up by Chalmers and a whistle. Foul goes on Rougeau. So Rougeau is gone. He fouls up. Ray Gumbel, take it away.
All right, Kevin, we're going to take everyone back to Anaheim. From now, Texas A&M, UCLA. Stanford prevails. Back to Omaha.
Second player for the Running Rebels has just fouled out. That was Rougeau. Finishes with 4. Rush can't get it. Here's Adams. Combination of Chalmers, Robinson, and Collins have combined for 31 of Kansas's 61 points tonight. 6.5 to play. Dancing is Adams. It's Shaw over Sasha Khan. Rebounded by Robinson. He's filling every category with his second rebound and a couple of assists. Kansas enjoying their biggest lead right now. Rush the drive and the reverse won't go, and the rebound by Curtis Terry. Approaching 6 to play in this one. Kansas trying to get to the Sweet 16. Taking on the 8th seeded UNLV Running Rebels. They made the Sweet 16 a season ago.
It has been a tremendous defensive effort by the Jayhawks of Kansas.
27% shooting and now even lower for UNLV.
Well, they're like 4 of 20 from beyond the arc now. They don't shoot the ball well from beyond the 3-point arc for the season, but certainly not that poor.
Chalmers from Collins. They went to double him. Collins free. Rebounded inside by Kendall Wallace. 5.5 to play.
Kansas doing a great job getting back on defense. And one of the most impressive things about the Jayhawks today, Kevin, there you imagine them as an up-and-down team that really gets out on the break, but they haven't been able to do that today, and yet they have dominated the game.
9 players have played for KU. Everyone has scored. Rick Adams was tripped as he took it inside. Looked like maybe Collins got a piece of him. Now Megan Robinson picks up his 3rd. As you can see, Jayhawks will take on the winner of Villanova and Siena. Badgers beat Kansas State here earlier tonight. They take on the winner of Davidson and Georgetown. 5:09 left. And just to extend that conversation on the Bill Self Kansas Jayhawk defense, they've allowed only a 3 of 14 shooting second half by the Running Rebels.
They have really contested everything that the Running Rebels have done. Now, the Running Rebels have been able to get to the free throw line. That's one reason they only have 14 shot attempts, but 3 field goals is, that's unbelievable defense in an NCAA tournament game.
Kansas led the Big 12 in field goal defense at 38%, number 9 in all of college basketball. Coming up is the games that a lot of our audience will be sent to after our conclusion here in Omaha tonight. Well, it was 46-41 with under 12 to go. Kansas has been dominant since, tightening the screws on defense, getting terrific penetrating guard play.
Well, they just have finally started to wear down this UNLV defense, and the Running Rebels have been outstanding on the defensive end all year long and most of the day today, but it's really hard to continue to play great defense when you just can't score.
And the backcourt has been the driving force for the Jayhawks tonight.
And that's exactly the correct word, Kevin, a driving force, because that's the way they've scored for the most part, taking the ball to the basket, a couple of 3-point shots thrown in here and there, but mostly it's been Robinson, it's been Collins, it's been Chalmers taking the ball to the basket.
Kendall Wallace picked up his 1st foul for UNLV, and at the free throw line is Mario Chalmers, who is absolutely terrific in one of the best college basketball games played this season nationwide in the Big 12 final at Kansas City at the Sprint Center against Texas. He nailed 8 threes, put up 30 points, dropped that on the Longhorns to win it. Terry off the screen. Collins was following. Chalmers is watching Kendall Wallace. And then they didn't know who to guard. And here's Darrell Arthur with the rebound. He's got 5.
I think Wallace was surprised he was so open on the inside.
I think everybody was surprised. Look at this, barreling down the lane. Sharon Collins has got 10. 13 from Robinson. Chalmers has 12. Hawks have carved out their biggest lead tonight over the Running Rebels of UNLV from the Mountain West Conference, the postseason champions.
And Adams has been the only offense really in the second half, and most of that offense has been from the free throw line.
It's Shaw. Robinson knocked it away. Got him on the arm. Russell Robinson picks up number 4 tomorrow night on 60 Minutes. A little stone box said to have a big connection to Jesus. That's tomorrow night on 60 Minutes. Shaw will be at the free throw line. And going back a little bit on this Running Rebel team. Now, this is a team, which we mentioned before, went to the Sweet 16, but they lost their starters of last year. And they were counting on 4 others to come in, and those 4 guys were gone. So really what Lon Kruger has done has been absolutely terrific in terms of coaching and getting the team this far.
Well, there's no question about it. We talked earlier in the game. This is a team that goes out there. They start 2 guys who began their careers as walk-ons, plus a former air conditioning repairman. And so Lon Kruger has just done a tremendous job getting these guys to play at a very high level. And there's a very high level defensively. They haven't shot the ball well all year long, but they've used their pressure to negate the other team's height advantage and wear them down by forcing turnovers. But that hasn't happened here today against an extremely talented Kansas squad.
Under 4 to play. Here is Chalmers finding Arthur. Great corkscrew move by Terrell Arthur. He's got 8 with 5 rebounds. Kansas 55% from the field, limiting UNLV to 26% from the floor. Adams with 23, only player from the Running Rebels in double figures tonight. Over Chalmers, rebound grabbed by Darnell Jackson, lassos his 9th of the night.
And UNLV still stuck on only 3 field goals scored in the second half. And the game becomes very easy when the ball goes in the basket, and it becomes almost impossible when the ball does not.
Here's Rush, 4 of 9.
He has done
big time triple.
He has done that. That now haven't been threes, but that particular move where he gives you that one hard dribble and rises up and shoots that jump shot. He's done that 4 or 5 times today.
He's got 12. Does Brandon Rush? Terry with a 3.
That's his first field goal attempt of the second half.
12 points for the game. Collins. Rush. Alley-oop for Jackson.
I'm going to call Rush for a charge.
Brandon Rush picks up the foul, and number 4 on him. The great spin move by Arthur. He's got 9. Rush trains the 3. It was 46-41. UNLV was down by 5, making a bit of a run. Then Kansas grabbed their throat and squeezed, put their foot down. They've outscored the Running Rebels by 26 in the lane. Rush is in there defending and has picked up the foul, and he is gone. He finishes the night with 12 points and a triple. Make it 2 threes for Brandon tonight.
Well, Wink Adams just comes cutting through the lane, and Rush, who has done a real good job preventing Adams from shooting those long-range shots, has had more difficulty as Adams has tried to take the ball to the basket.
Listen to this balance scoring by Kansas tonight. 13 from Russell Robinson, 12 from Mario Chalmers, 10 from Collins, 9 from Arthur, 8 from Jackson, who also grabbed 9 rebounds. I mean, let's take a look at the landscape of college basketball. Is there any more balanced team than this one?
I don't think so. This is one of those teams where you can't really get after one or two guys. You know, we heard Tim Floyd from USC tell us on Wednesday that most college teams, two guys score 50% of their points. But certainly that's not the case here with Kansas. They are very, very well balanced. You just don't know who you defend. You try to defend everybody, and they just slice you up.
14 of the 24 from Wink Adams have come at the free throw line tonight. A lot of our audience will go watch number one seed UCLA in Anaheim against ninth seeded Texas A&M and former Kansas guard Mark Turgeon coaching the Aggies.
Adams has made 15 free throws tonight.
He's 15 for 17 from the line.
He did start on that Sweet 16 team a season ago. Two to play. Hawks are going to advance. They'll go to 33-3.
But a tremendous season for UNLV. You mentioned before they lost four of their starters. They lost their top guy off the bench. They lost four other guys that before the season they were counting on. And yet they have put together, they finished second in the Mountain West during the regular season, won the conference tournament, and won a first-round game against a very, very good Kent State team.
Chalmers went down hard as he got the two face first on the floor with a minute and a half to play.
Count the basket by Mario Chalmers.
And a guy who is so important to this team on both ends of the floor. You could feel the thud all the way over here.
Well, you could feel the thud, but he watches Chalmers drives to the basket. His eyes are on the goal. And he goes down very hard because he's completely given up his body going in there. And if you're the Jayhawks of Kansas, your only concern right now, this game is already won. You don't want to lose one of your key guys headed into next week.
We mentioned before that he was a player of the year in the state of Alaska. Think of all the prominent college basketball players over the last handful of years from that state. There's his father right there,
who's the director of basketball operations at Kansas.
Carlos Boozer, Trajan Langdon, Ramon Harris at Kentucky, and Mario Chalmers of the Jayhawks. Russell Robinson seems like it's a new card every night for the Jayhawks, and tonight Robinson puts in 13. 14 from Chalmers, who's at the stripe right now. Tough kid. Hawks are right over the ninth consecutive win. There's a screen by Shaw, three by Terry, a rebound by Sharon Collins. This Kansas team will remind you a little bit of the first Florida championship team, the balance, the depth, the overall feel.
I think that's a pretty good comparison. And this is a Kansas team that will now go to play the winner of Siena and Villanova, a 13 seed and a 12 seed.
Chalmers for three, uncovered, right down the pipe. He's got a Kansas high 17. Chalmers has tonight nailed two threes. So the Jayhawks will be going to the Sweet 16 with their win tonight over UNLV. They will take on the winner of Villanova with a surprise win and Siena. They will play tomorrow. Wink Adams with a terrific effort tonight with 25 points, 15 at the stripe, but did not hit a three. Three-point shooting would have been the great equalizer in this game as Kansas has brought in Kleinman and Tehan, Case, Cole Aldrich, and the reigning Kansas Basketball Player of the Year, Terrell Reed. In fact, they got the Kansas Player of the Year in Reed and the Missouri High School Player of the Year in Connor Tehan from Kansas City Rockhurst. You talk about deep, you talk about recruiting.
That's how you win so many games. You have players.
Reed comes up with it. As the Rock Chalk chant fills the Quest Center here in downtown Omaha. Self is shaking him off. He does not want him to score. He's not wanting to shoot.
It's pretty tough to ask kids in an NCAA tournament game. I haven't played.
If they do get in the box score, and Kansas will have the win. beating the eighth-seeded Run Rebels of UNLV 75-56. Kansas is going to the Sweet 16.
Greg Gumbel in New York, so number one seed in the Midwest. The Kansas Jayhawks move on with a 75-56 win over UNLV.